7-month process, and men we're getting ready to, and women we're getting ready to bring out, have dedicated several hours a week, and even nights, and all times of work, all types of hours, to really put into what it means to transform our city. And it's my belief that in many ways, I think about those public servants officers who are people who go out and risk their lives on a day-to-day basis because of, you know, to address and keep peace in our community. One of the things that I hear from particularly those who are first responders is that one of the most important things is coming home at night, right? And so it's not lost on me the sacrifice that people who are on the front lines that they take. And so in the efforts to really increase the capacity of those who work in the city, we developed this Peace Academy, bringing together those who have been doing work in the city, bringing together some of the best practices as far west from organizations in California like the Urban Peace Institute, east organizations like the Institute for Nonviolence, and now the Institute for Nonviolence Chicago, and even here to our very own Cure Violence that has both a national, a local, and an international reputation. We brought together the best practices of those three, as well as other organizations and entities around the country and the world, to really figure out, you know, how we can get out on these streets and create communities of peace in this world. And the people who went through this academy, they've seen, you know, some of the worst that sometimes our world, our society has to offer. They've been through some of the worst of that. And they've come through, and so in many ways, they are our most resilient that we have in our cities. And now, coupled with the work that they've come together to do, I think we're very honored to be able to have them as ambassadors and leaders in the fight against violence in the city. So without further ado, won't you please rise and stand?